And I'm back in Nullius, and we have gotten all this built. So that's what we were doing at the end of the last episode, was expanding our carbon dioxide setup. And success, we have expanded it. I think this is enough chimneys, maybe. So we'll see. We'll keep an eye on it. We have more carbon dioxide than we need. And I suspect we will now face some problems with our carbon dioxide backing up, because like the steel is outputting carbon dioxide, and when it gets too full, we won't be able to make steel anymore. So we'll have to, you know, think of some clever ways to pump the carbon dioxide out of here into the main supply so that these distilleries get backed up. But these steel foundries, and I think there's another, let's just see. Here we go. That pipe visualizer is excellent. It's coming up here, and we're going to have another. Wow, okay. Well, we're consuming it with filters, but here's the output. Yeah, the sludge. I knew there was another output of carbon dioxide, so this might get backed up as well. All right. Cool. Finish that. And what are we going to do this episode? Well, I believe we are kind of low on power. These wind turbines are hit or miss. And how's our hydrogen? Our hydrogen is empty because we are out of power. These electrolyzers only work when we have power. So we have actually unlocked a excellent new tech that we can go ahead and start using. So let's look at these solar thermal generators. I think there's a couple different buildings that work together here. And this is one way you can use Factory Planner, is for kind of like a mall type thing where you want a set number of items. So like these solar collectors, like if you want 100 solar collectors, you can then get the raw ingredients that you need. So for 100 solar collectors, ignore the fact that this is a rate per minute. And just look, we need 400 heat pipes, 300 steel rods, etc., etc. So that's one thing you can do to make that easy on you. And, well, actually, I don't know how many solar collectors we need. The idea is that we use these like solar panels, just plop them down. They do have a neighbor bonus, which is just fascinating. So neighbor bonus of 10%. And I believe it's a maximum of 4 neighbors, right? I don't think the diagonal neighbors count. I wonder if you arrange them like an octagon pattern, or like a hexagon pattern, if the partial side bonuses will give 10%. I don't think so. So we'll assume 40% neighbor bonus is the max. What's 140% of 150? That is 210. I have a calculator. I wasn't doing that in my head. 210 watts. So probably just call it 200. Each one is going to output 200 watts. Make it easy for us. And that's an average. So during the day, we need to store the heat for the nighttime. So we'll have tanks for storing steam. And we also just store heat in these heat pipes as well. And in the solar collectors and the heat exchangers. You know, it's like nuclear. It doesn't have to run the whole time. You'll still get the heat from it. Okay, so let's see. 200 watts per solar collector. And then we use these heat exchangers to turn heat energy into steam. And each one does, 1,800 watts. Yeah, megawatts. So let's see. Divided by 200, that's 9 of these solar collectors for every one heat exchanger, and call it maybe 10. Yeah, let's call it 10 solar collectors for one heat exchanger. We can do a sort of a square. You want to as close to a square as possible to put these solar collectors in, that way you'll get the most neighbor bonuses possible. So if we did a 4x5 grid square rectangle of solar collectors, 4x5 would go into 2 heat exchangers. All right, so that's what I wanted to do. We want 20 of these, right click in order to change the amount, and we want 2 heat exchangers And so basically I just want to check that we can make all this stuff, because we have a little bit of glass being made. Okay, this is just furnaces and tanks. Okay, yeah, I think we have enough glass for what we want to do. Let's just add some more heat pipes in. And what are heat pipes? We'll find out. Probably we need something like 20 heat pipes for each little module of this. Not quite sure. But aluminum sheets we should be able to do pretty easily, right? Yeah. Just some ingots into these foundries. We can set that up now. We have pipes. Everything we have. Good. I was worried we would need silicon or like an exorbitant amount of glass. But I think we're going to be okay. Oh, you know what? I messed up down here. I noticed I messed up these pipes. This stuff isn't working. Even when we have hydrogen, it's not working. Let's see here. This wasn't getting ethylene. Not because we don't have ethylene, but because... Yeah. This needs to go into my ethylene. Okay. And... Is that going to reach? No, that's not going to reach. And that's carbon dioxide. Okay. So good. Now ethylene is coming in here. Because we do have a little benzene. We do have propane. And then I think this one isn't working either. The output of hydrogen is full, which should not happen because the hydrogen here is not full. So, oh, yeah. Pipe visualizer could be helpful here if I just paid attention to it. That's not a regular pipe. That's an underground pipe. All right, and now we've got hydrogen. And so let's see, that was our rubber, right? Yeah, now we're making rubber. Okay. Cool, and we're flickering some butadiene and styrene into these tanks every once in a while. All right. Okay, so let's set up now that I think I've fixed some of this stuff. Where am I going? I want to go to my steel. Let's set up some temporary, very temporary steel processing here. So we need rods. And then I think, what else do we need? Just rods, I guess, huh? Oh, wait a second. We need medium assemblers. Well, we can handcraft solar collectors, but heat pipes we cannot. Handcraft. We actually do need medium assemblers, not small assemblers. And I think medium assemblers we have researched. Yes, and they require steel beams. Aren't you glad I looked at that? And last thing I wanted to make with our temporary steel is these good medium tanks, which we need steel sheets for. Okay. So steel sheets are like the iron sheets, which I've done. They require these steel plates. Okay, let's power this bad boy up. We do need a power pole there. And steel beams are just from ingots, but then the sheets require the secondary product of the plates. Okay. And do I want some plates? I think I do want some plates. Now let's see. I don't want to go crazy with the steel, but I do want to make sure I have enough. Okay, and 60 steel rods is all we need for, this is like, yeah, this is a single module. And maybe we could make two. So let's just double this. I don't think that's crazy, right? We could even quadruple it. And that would be a couple, I think steel rods probably stack to 200. So that would be a couple slots worth of steel rods there. Cool. Whew. If you can't tell, I'm a little sick. So my voice might be a little weird. Might be a little off this episode. Why isn't this inserter waiting for space? Oh, because it's full. Okay. We're good. I was... weirded out by that inserter holding graphite and the furnace not having graphite. How's our stone and our gravel? It's maybe fine. I'm not sure. All right, let's see how much glass we have. We might want to set up 250. Excellent. And okay, so that'll get us two of these modules. I think that's fine. And then we can set up some legitimate sandstone processing, which we have yet to do. Hilarious. All right, and then aluminum. And where do I want to set up my aluminum? I think I want to set it up in the mall. Why not? And yeah, this can just be sort of temporary. So, what do I need for this? And what is the new thing I have? Oh yeah, silicon. Which I thought maybe I needed for the thermal collectors, but I don't. I need... Wait, what do I need here? Oh, not a chem plant. I need a foundry. Silly me. Foundry does our metal intermediates. And let's see here. Sheets, was it? Yeah, sheets. So we need plates, and then... sheets. Okay. And into here. How much do we need? We need five... More than 400. Because I want to double this. More than 400. And these stack to 100, I assume. So something like that should do the trick. Now, are my inserters keeping up, or is this an obnoxious bottleneck? Okay, we're fine. Probably. Yeah, we're fine. Okay. All right. So, let's see here. Ooh, 10 minutes in and I've done... I mean, I've done not much. I still have this red science. Should I just go put it in? Should I put it into my lab? Where is my lab? Oh, it's all the way up here. Ta-da! We got the red science in there. I know that's been bugging you guys. All right, and what can I make? Oh, I need heat pipes. Ah, of course. And that requires water, and that's our medium assembler, which I can make now. Oh, yeah. I guess I can make a bunch of them. Oh, yeah, we can make, we can do tanks. Let's set up heat pipes, and then we can go finally get our tanks going. I think I've tried to do that twice now. All right, yeah, I was looking for water here. And do I want to bring water? Places. I do want to bring water places, but I think right now, why don't we just do a temporary heat pipe thing right here. We need the sheets. And we need power. And we will want a chest. Actually, I mean, I could just... Nah, whatever. Chest is fine. Alright, let's see how much of this aluminum we have so far. And plenty to get started. Okay, and then while this stuff is running... What do we want to do? What do we want to do? Set up sandstone, or let's see, plastic's not running because the propane. So that makes sense. That makes sense. All right. Oh, there was something I wanted to do here. I wanted to make sure we were getting gravel. Yeah. Yep. We're getting gravel disposal, even if our chlorine... Well, let's see. Why aren't we flowing the chlorine into our gravel? It's because we're backed up on caustic, and I have this set up that it's not going to pump the chlorine out of this tank if we are full of caustic, because I didn't want these to run unnecessarily. However, we are not disposing of our chlorine the way I want to. There's our gravel, excuse me. We're not disposing of our gravel the way I want to. So, I want to change this to basically an or gate. I want the chlorine to be pumped out if the caustic solution is low or if we need gravel disposal. And one way to check if we need gravel disposal is, yeah, this is going to work, is if our hydrogen chloride is low. If our hydrogen chloride is low, we want to pump this chlorine out, even if the caustic solution is full. So, I got a picker dolly mod for just such an occasion. That lets me shift up. Yeah. And that way the red wire stays lit up. And we're going to have two pumps. That's the easy way to do an ore gate in this setup. I need... what are these called? Motors. I need motors. Oh, well. We'll handcraft them. Okay. And now I want this to pump if... Oh, we also... Oh, it's this relief valve, actually. Wow. Let's just take that away for now. Oof. Yeah, we'll take that away. But then I need a tank here to sense my hydrogen chlorine level. Ah, you know what? If we did a small tank... Cool. And... I'll handcraft some medium tanks too right now because we also have a checkpoint where we place six medium tanks. Or not medium. Medium tank twos. We place 6 of those, I think, and we get a checkpoint. Okay, small tanks, I think, are going to let me put this in line. That's all we need. Yeah, that's cool. So I like that all these tanks have different kind of configurations for their inputs and outputs. Very cool. All right, if I put it here, I think I can get a red wire to reach. What do you guys think? Yeah, baby. All right, and let's see. We said pump it if the hydrogen chlorine is low. How low? Like 1,000? And okay, hydrogen chlorine is certainly low. I can rejigger those pipes to make it easier. And so we will be pumping out our chlorine now. And hopefully that's not a disaster. Oh, we're out of power, baby. All right, come on, let's go. Let's get power. What are we waiting on? Heat pipes? They're in the chest. 71 heat pipes. Aluminum sheets. Hopefully we have more aluminum sheets. I know we're out of power. Okay, we got aluminum sheets. Steel rods, 2 of those. Heat exchangers. We need extra heat pipes, don't we? We have extra heat pipes. And then we have some medium tank tubes. So we need more of this stuff. Oh, that's a lot of steel rods, baby. Let's go. And we also need steel sheets. Okay. Oh, yeah, and I said I wanted to set up medium tank ones. Yeah, we can do that. Let's see. Where was the stuff? It's pretty simple, right? Pipes, iron rods, iron sheets. So if I put it down here, it's super easy. We just want... let's see. The output there, and then don't pick up my relief valves. That's very confusing. Maybe I should put this over on the other side, just so I don't get super confused. Okay, and then rods and sheets, which I put these on the, these are just very wrong. You should not put rods with the wires. You should put probably rods with plates, because a lot of stuff just use rods and plates. Anyways, I guess it wouldn't have helped in this situation, but still. All right, and how do I do this? I think that should work. Something like Shift L, and I put an iron wire on that belt. Hilarious. And I picked up the wrong thing here. Oh, that's not what I wanted. All right. Silly me. Shift L there. All righty. And now we're making tanks. Definitely don't want more than a stack of them, though. Okay, and we've got some things that we need. And... heat pipes. How are we on heat pipes? Okay, we've got some more. Not enough for 20... and the heat pipes, but I think we can get started. Let's place it down in this power section. Oh, we need water, don't we? Hey, look at that, water. All right, let's see if we can fit something nice within here and nice and tileable so we can just go down as needed. How about I take a second and think about it, design it a little bit, and then I'll loop you guys in. Okie dokie. Had some time to think, and what I want to do is I want to cram this in. I think I'll be able to do it. I need 5, let's see, 5 wide, I decided 4 wide, 5 down, and then I can cram all the other stuff between the left side of here and this windmill, and that way I can just tile it down and not have to worry about running into my windmill farm. So let's see, we need heat pipes to connect these all together, and then we'll be able to put, let's see here, these heat exchangers, and we could do efficient water boiling. Or we could do inefficient seawater boiling. And for now, I think I want to do inefficient seawater boiling. That way I don't have to worry about piping my water over here. I just have seawater coming from these lakes close by. And then we'll have to get wastewater out. Now, I did unlock something that will allow me to tile this nicely. And that was chirality. I forgot to look it up and see how it's pronounced. But we can mirror buildings after placing using the asterisk in the numpad. So let's see here. Asterisk. Yeah, very cool. It flips it. So now we can have our seawater all coming in the same side. Very nice. All right, and I think I want to have this down away from here because I want to put these nice tanks right up against it like that. Yep, because that I need, I think, yep, I need that exact distance here for the tanks. And let's see, will I be able to, yeah, that's perfect, right? Perfect. All right, cool. And then how are we gonna get the wastewater out? Well, we'll just figure it out. I'll put undergrounds all the way over there and it'll be easy. Same with the seawater, just an underground running all the way to the west. Okay, and I need to cram this up. Now, wait, what are the pipes? Oh, I didn't pick up those pipes when I cut. Now I want the top. Well, what do I want? Yeah, I think I want it like so, with this pipe sticking up. And that means that I'll need to make sure I don't use this space here, so that when I tile it, that pipe can stick up a little bit into this one above it. Okay, and now I figured out I need three, what's it called? Turbine things? To actually turn the steam into power. So let's see, a max power 1 megawatt, and it doesn't change if I change it correctly to backup. I want these backup turbines. Cool, okay. Actually, do I want backup turbines? No, I don't want them backup turbines. I want these standard, baby. Let's go. Power all the time for my surge electrolyzers. Yeah, standard turbines will power my surge generators, right? My surge electrolyzers, right? Yes, they will. Of course they will. Okay, anyways, 1 megawatt for each turbine, which makes it pretty easy to calculate as long as I can get steam. So let's see. Pretty sure these heat exchangers will be running full time ish. Oh, well, actually, no, they won't, will they? They'll be running part time and then I'll collect the steam here. Or I'm not sure. Huh. Yeah, we might need extra heat pipes actually to like store the heat. Oh, now I'm not sure. Darn it. Oh, well, you guys tell me what I did wrong. I probably want, let's see, I want more heat exchangers, so that during the heat of the day, I can turn all the heat into steam. Yeah, probably. But I don't think I'll be able to then, get it to all fit nice and neat in one little box. So I think, I don't know. This isn't gonna be perfect. But anyways, 6 kilojoules per steam, and we get 235 of them, which is 1,400. So that's less than 3,000, less than 3 megajoules. So for every 2 of these, 3 turbines will be able to go through it. Maybe I should calculate that heat capacity. Yeah, if I get extra heat pipes, will I store the heat? Or do I want a third heat exchanger to turn the heat into steam? So fewer turbines, more tanks. That's probably, oh, not rotate. Probably what I want to do. Okay, let's see here. And so if I did something like that. Why don't I just, instead of trying to cram, yeah, this is what I'll do. Instead of trying to cram the turbines, into here, why don't I just, fill up this little box with tanks? That's perfect. All right. Perfect, perfect, perfect. And, ooh, hang on. No, that won't work. Yeah. So I want three of these. I can't really get four unless I change it so that tanks aren't all together, huh? Well, hopefully three will be enough. I know I calculated the exact ratio, 9 to 1, but we'll go three, I guess. All right, this should work. Okay. And seawater going in there. Oops, I don't want to put it down because I guess I do want it right here, don't I? I think I figured it out. I think this is how I want it. Okay, that sounds good. Oh, and then are these going to connect up here? No, they're not going to connect together, which is fine, I think. Let's turn on my roboports because this is probably good. Probably good. I don't really want to get trapped here. And I definitely need more of these things, don't I? Okay, oops. And I need a couple more storage tanks. And another, what was it? Where is it? There it is. Okay. Let's go make more of the things. The collectors. I'm assuming we need, oh, tanks. Let's grab tanks. We got the tanks. Well, sure, I'll just take them all. Okay. And then, how much of that do I have? A ton of that. Let's go. And then I can only, I don't need to store as much anymore, do I? Let's go get heat pipes. Oh, wait. Oh my gosh, I forgot. Oh, all that time wasted. Oh well. Oh well. It's a sad day for us all, I know. Sure. Alright. I wonder how my gravel's doing now that I kind of rejiggered that. Oh, it is pretty fast to craft, so that's nice. And how many more can we get? Oh, we can. Yeah, we can get them all, and we just need heat pipes. Alright. Let's see. Is this working now? We have hydrogen chloride, that's why it's not pumping. And yes, we have a little bit of chlorine in case we needed plastic here. We are pumping all the chlorine we want to clear away the gravel. Now, if I remember, we need to expand this part because, I mean, you can see we've got plenty of inputs and plenty of space for the outputs to go, but that's not good enough, is it? Let's see. Is that gonna work? I think that'll work. Do I want lights everywhere? I don't know that I want lights everywhere. And if I remember, it was 6. Should I look at this? I never did that, huh? Did I delete it? Fascinating. Oh no, here it is. Oh, maybe we only need 3. Oh, this isn't right. Maybe it is right. I don't know. Alright, what am I missing? Pipes, huh? Okay, let's go grab some of the bad pipes. I guess I could change it to good pipes, but who cares? Who cares? The bad pipes work just fine, and we need them for the intermediate stuff anyway. Ow. I hate when I get stuck at times 4 speed. Alright. Help my bots out a little. And let's see. This might be where we start needing to pump out the carbon dioxide to ensure that we don't have any issues. I could also use a small tank. Why not? Let's see. Oh, the small tanks also have those fun... oh my gosh. What if we did that? Can I do it? maybe not. Sorry, I'm trying to think. How can I? Yeah, I guess not. I was thinking I could. Well, it's kind of nice like that. Let's just do like so. Oh, wait. Oh, no, I can do it. I can do it. Right? If this is here, it all is going to work. And then I can pump it out. Man, my mind is in a fog. Having a cold. Oof. I don't recommend it. If you can avoid getting a cold, try to not do that. All right, I'm thinking if I... No, it doesn't matter. I was going to say I can make all these red pipes so that the carbon dioxide flows a little better. And let's see, that's an input over there, so it's fine. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. I think that'll clear. Maybe not. We have too much carbon dioxide, huh? All right, so what can I do to alleviate that? Let's see. We want to bottleneck... these by making sure all this is red pipes, maybe? What happens when I do that? Just clearing up some stuff while we wait for heat pipes to be made, I guess. I think we're actually good on heat pipes, aren't we? So let's... Yeah, perfect. We'll upgrade these to the good pipes, and I think that's all we might need. Possibly. And now, is this gonna pump out? Nope, it's not. Oh well. Maybe it'll be fine. If not, we can deal with it. Alright, heat pipes. And, sure. Give me more. Alright, let's go see if this thermal generator thing is giving us steam. It's not. Oh yeah, we need to figure out the water. But it's getting heat. It is getting heat. Cool, and we've got our little module going. Alright. So let's get wastewater. How do we want to do this? So I think I'm going to make this all nice and tileable here. Like on this side. So we can tile the, you know, we can tile this down like so, and then we can tile this side over here as well. All right. Oh, I'm realizing this isn't going to be perfectly tileable. I need a thing like this. Actually, maybe I don't. What if I did it? Something like that. Could do that. And then we'll pump it. Pump it like so. We need a... Nothing else needs power, right? Nothing else needs power. Okay, I just need to hook this up. Alright, and that's just connected to our main power. Yes, it's connected to our main power. Okay. I think I'm just gonna landfill this. Alright, that's our steam. We need, desperately, need to get our water going. So, hook it up like that. Oh wait, are these the right things? Let's see, wastewater. And wastewater, yeah. I can be confident it's the right things because they're connected on the right side and the left side appropriately. All right. What else do I need? The inputs and the outputs. An outfall, which would be nice if I could just do like that, which I can. Excellent. And I should have done the input first. That would have been more exciting. Oh, well. And then the... input, which of course we need powered. Yeah, humbug. And maybe I don't want my power to run through where I know my turbines are going to be, huh? Okay, so we've got water. And these things are working. We're getting steam. And now we just need two. Excellent. Maybe I should put tanks over here, too. Will that help? I don't think that'll help. No worries. All right, open turbines. And this should be really straightforward, shouldn't it? How many did we say? Well, I guess we can put a bunch in. Maybe we do want more tanks over here. And standard, yeah, standard. Alright, no steam, huh? Oh yeah, we don't have heat. Fluid ingredient shortage. Oh, we need more water. Excellent. Turning all the water I can get into power. That is just fantastic. I'll take it. All right, is that powered? It is powered. That does not look like that small power pole should reach, huh? But it does. And what do you know? We've got plenty of seawater. Oh, I didn't craft that. Ah. It went down. Wait, I do have a combustion chamber. Why aren't I? Oh, it's not combustion chamber. It's heat exchanger, of course. Which need combustion chambers, so it's not like I was wasting precious resources here. And do I need another heat exchanger? I believe I do. And then we'll need some storage tanks, and everything's good. Everything's good. Whew, okay. Oh, did I get the checkpoint? I didn't even notice that. I did not get the checkpoint. Why didn't I get the checkpoint? Well, it's 10. Well, I definitely have 10. So it must be relief valves, which I have. I can just do that. There we go. I just didn't have quite 6 of them placed, huh? All right, more solar collectors, and then I think everything is going to be peachy. Oh, the output's full. We don't need the power. Our surge electrolyzers are running at full speed. Excellent. This is very exciting. Very exciting. Where are my electrolyzers? Good. We have plenty of water, hopefully. Maybe. We could use more. Output full. Okay, so yes, we have plenty of water. The output's full. It's just these little pipes can only get a little bit of water, eh? And cool. Output full there. And it's not the wastewater backing up. How are these things doing? Oh, output. The sludge is full. Did I mess up the sludge thing? What is happening? Oh, yeah, I messed it up. Whoops! All right, let's go fix that and pick up the heat pipes so we can make more of those solar things. And phew, now that we have power, we can get this party started. I think that's going to give me lots of extra power. Where am I going? Up here. Hopefully that'll give me lots of extra power. Hopefully. All right, good. And I think that should be plenty of sludge disposal, whatever it's called. And heat pipes. Need more pipes. And we can craft 10 more of these, but I can't because I don't have aluminum. Okie dokie. Let's see, do I have plenty of these bad pipes? I do. Do I have plenty of the good pipes? That's what I needed. Okay. Whew. Get to the aluminum. All right, 5. I think I need 5 more, and that was all I needed, I think. We'll just wait for those to handcraft and be done. Be done? I don't know if that being done. Let's see here. Do I have those tanks? I do have those tanks. Anything else I need? I'm just waiting on the collectors, huh? All right. And now those are generating. The pipes are heating up. These things are all connected. Pipe visualizer. I mean, you can obviously still miss things. That's quite the spaghetti, but it looks like we're good. We probably have enough outfalls. We probably have enough seawater, maybe, but the temperature's low, so it's hard to tell. Oh, this temperature's... Ah, the heat pipe's not connected. Oops. All right, and then anytime we want more, we can do something like that. Cool. Well, oh yeah, and we need to connect. Okay. All right, we're not done yet. We're not done yet. Those things. They're in chemistry, huh? Oh, I just can't do it because I don't have motors. All right, guys. Well, I guess we can... Let's see. What's related to power? Oh, we can clear out, like, our propane and benzene. That could work. What was I coming up here to get? Motors. Motors. And I guess I could steal some more filters. My inventory's filling up, huh? Valves are good. Oh, now that we have medium assemblers, we can work on our maul. That's always a good idea. Let's work on our maul. And then I'm going to have to go, even though it's not going to be quite an hour. So, all right, what should we automate at our maul now that we have this? What about windmills? Oh, open turbines. That'll be a good one. Which, yeah, requires medium assemblers. Motors are on a belt now. Good. Do we also need pipes? We do. All right, so I would like to extend things up, you know, to our mall. I had the idea what am I thinking? Like, what if I ran these belts up? We just need to clear out the filters. Yeah, let's do that. Because I didn't like that filter placement anyways. How's my inventory? I'll just pause for you guys. And just like that, I've put these things together. So now we have some belts going here. And, yeah, and what... I mean, what's the point of that? I forget. Oh, yeah, it's so that I could then have part of my mall running up this way. Nice. I could even make more motors, more motor assemblers, huh? What happens if I just do this? Does just all hell break loose? I don't think so. I think we're okay. I think it'll be fun. I think we'll be able to do it pretty quickly. Is that backwards? What is happening here? Oh, we need plastic. Oh, that's the problem with that. Oh, well. No problem. And yeah, that's where it goes. Okay. And then we need plastic running like so. What a silly way to do things. You're like, why? What on earth? What on earth are you doing? Well, it's because I want the mall to actually be over up here where my mall is. So we're just going to do it nice and slow, and it'll all be good, alright? Alright, more power poles. And plastic. And now our motors. Got more motors. Okay. So that will let us... I don't even know. What does that let us do? Who knows? Oh, you know what? I haven't done anything like this before, but we can, let's see, make pipes like so. Oh, wait, all we need are iron rods? Okay, never mind. But cool, that'll work. Alright, pipes, and what if we put pipes with plastic? That could be fun. So I've made it so that it goes on the short side of the belt. Excellent. Now we have pipes, motors, gears, all the iron intermediates, and we can now... I totally forgot what I was going to do. Open turbines. We got it. We got it. In a medium assembler. And iron sheets. Cool. I need to remember to do the control R, don't I? Alright, we need all of those... And then we need the pipes. Shift L. Okay. Open turbines. That should come in handy. Because those are used in windmills. Oops, not shift. It's control. Those are used in windmills. Those are used just for turbines, which we need. Those are used for maybe some other things. Maybe that was it. Well, I will like to have windmills automated. So... If it's only windmills, that's just dandy. Where the heck are those? Down here. Oh, air filters? Yeah. Apparently I can make generators to put in my inventory. Who cares? Closed turbines? Open turbines too? Yeah, we'll continue to need those turbines. Sure. And then, let's see, windmills. Do I need to make those in a medium assembler? I do. And what else are windmills? Plastic? No, power poles. Okay, and power poles can be small, right? Plastic rods and the coils. Okay. Pick up my power poles. And let's see. That's coming from... this bad boy. And then it was plastic. Something like that. Oh, and rods. Oh, which I'm getting. I'm getting rods. I think that... Yeah, that inserter can do it all. And... Oh, that can't go there because I need the inserter. Taking it here. I can't wait to unlock all of those nice inserter position things. I love this mod. I love the Bob Adjustables inserter mod. Perhaps I should say. Alright, now we've got plenty of windmills. Let's see, do I want that much? Or do I want more? Maybe I want more. So that when we go crazy, we can just really go crazy with it. Alright guys, I gotta go. It's almost... 7 hours. So I'm pleased and hope you are too. We've worked on power this episode. We've automated windmills, which is exciting. We don't have plastic. Why don't we have plastic? Hopefully we have plenty of power now, which I can't really tell. Let's see here. Our open standard turbines... they're giving us 4 megawatts, so that's much better than not getting 4 megawatts. Our electrolyzers are still low power, though, so we haven't solved anything. Before I go, I can... Let's see, hold on. Do I have... Where... Darn it. Oh, yeah, of course I have open turbines now. What am I thinking? Of course I do. Wait, I've sucked them all up. No. No. Don't put them all into windmills. Unbelievable. Disaster. Okay, well, I can just make open turbines. Okay. Alright. And... Yeah, that's all I needed. And let's see, steam is... Yeah, a medium amount of steam, which is, like, perfect. I was hoping for a medium amount of steam. And then these have plenty of steam getting to them. We don't have throughput issues there. Oh, we need a pipe. I mean a pump. I'm so glad I didn't miss that. That would have been so annoying. Sorry for the sniffles, you guys. I hope you understand. These are all working good. How's our heat? Our temperature looks pretty good. Yeah, so the max temperature is 250, so they're not even getting there. Which means I think I'm storing power, storing heat. Maybe okay. Let's see, what are the solar... Yeah, I mean, we're at the heat of the day. We're halfway through the day, almost to night. Yeah, I think this is a good sign. Output's full, which means we should have plenty of power for our surge electrolyzers. Yes, those are running. Excellent. Right over here. Good. The chlorine ones are full. Why are they full, actually? Shouldn't they be pumping this caustic solution? Ah, no, I only get rid of the caustic when the chlorine is low. But it is low. I just need it lower than that. Okay, all right. I want to fix that. And then call it an episode. All right. So let's see. This pump. Oh, less than 500? That's ridiculous. 3,000. We could also change that to a good tank, couldn't we? Anything else we should change to a good tank? Oh, the caustic solution. Let's change that to a good tank. Okay, so now those are gonna run, yeah? As long as this can run. Hold on here. Ah, we need better inserter. Okay, but I can do it with... Let's see. What on earth? I accidentally rotated the whole thing. Alright, I rotated that way, and then I long inserter, and now we can... Oh, that even goes way faster than the other one. Alright. Well, much better. Okay. Now these are running. Hopefully, sort of running. And we've got hydrogen chloride. We're getting more chlorine. Okay, things are good. And I'm going to call it. We've got 7 hours. We've got extra power. We can't see it because I don't have my radar, my sensor node. What's it called? My sensor node. How do I make more sensor nodes? I don't think I can do that for a long time. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this episode. And I will see you next time when we work towards purple science. I believe it's electrical science. So I'm looking forward to that immensely. And I'll catch you guys then.